Hello everyone, welcome back to iRender's tutorial series. Today's tutorial is a special one, inspired by the iconic Starry Night by Vincent Van Gogh. We're going to bring this masterpiece to life by creating a beautiful dynamic motion using the new Particles System in Cinema 4D. Before we dive in, let's take a quick look at the animation you'll be able to create by the end of this tutorial. Ready? Let's get started. We'll begin by recreating the basic elements of Van Gogh's Starry Night painting. Start by creating a plane with dimensions that match the painting, like in the video, where we use 320 by 260 centimeters. Adjust the segments to correspond with the size. Next, we'll set up the material. Create a new standard material in Classic Materials. Click to edit the material, turn off the reflectance channel, and in the color channel, link the texture to the image of the painting. In this tutorial, we're using Van Gogh's Starry Night. Apply the material to the plane and rename it Painting. In the Material tag, you can adjust the projection and other parameters to fit the painting perfectly. Right-click on Painting, go to the other tags, and select Vertex Color. Create a shader field, and in the Field tab, choose the channel as Color. In the Material tag, select the standard material that you applied to the painting. For Strength, use the Gray option, and you can select Invert if necessary. In the Vertex Color tag, apply the shader field you just created. Now, right-click on Painting, create a vertex map, and add the shader field you just created to Fields. Increase the contrast using a range map, adjusting the settings to get the desired effect. Then, create a polygon selection with fields set to the vertex map you just created. Finally, create a vertex map invert and a polygon selection invert using the same steps as before. Next, we'll use the Volume Builder and Field Force to add depth and motion to our scene. Start by creating a Volume Builder and set the volume type to Vector with a voxel size of 1 cm. Next, create a Group Field. Inside the Group Field, add a Random Field and leave the Noise type as Perlin by default. Scale it up to 600% and set the Direction to Normalize. Mask this Random Field using the Shader Field we created earlier. In Objects of the Volume Builder, add Painting and Group Field. Set the Creation Space to Object Below and change the mode to Cross. Then add Vector Smooth, Vector Curl, and Vector Normalize, all to the Volume Builder. Now create a field force. In the Object tab, add the volume builder you just created and choose it as the volume object. Mask this volume builder using the shader field. Next, go to the Simulate menu under Particles and choose Emitters. Create a mesh emitter. In the Emission tab, set the geometry to Painting. Adjust the velocity speed to 0 cm in the properties of the mesh emitter. Also, change the rate to per frame. Press play to check the result. You'll notice the particles are spreading outside the painting, not quite following our intended flow. Go back to the Field Force. In the Object tab, set the velocity type to Set Absolute Velocity and Strength to 50. Press play, and now the particles will flow along the surface of the painting, following the direction of the field force. In the Random field, feel free to experiment with different seed values, noise types, and scale settings until you achieve the desired effect. Now it's time to bring everything to life using the new particle system in Cinema 4D. To have the particles inherit the painting's material color, go to the Property Maps tab in Mesh Emitter. For Color Map, select the painting's vector color that we created earlier. Press play to check the result. In the Emission tab, for Restriction, choose the painting's Polygon Selection Invert to control the surface area where the particles are emitted. Create multiple mesh emitters, adjusting the parameters such as restriction, color map, rate, lifetime, and more, using the painting's polygon selection and painting's vertex color map until you're satisfied with the effect. In the Draw tab of the Particle Group, you can set the Draw mode to Lines. This will help you see the patterns and flow created by the particles as they move across the surface of the painting more clearly. And there it is, We've just transformed one of the most famous paintings in the world into a beautiful, moving piece of art using Cinema 4D. The particles are swirling and dancing just like the brush strokes, mimicking the motion of the stars and sky in the masterpiece. We hope this tutorial has inspired you to explore new ways of blending classic art with modern technology. If you enjoyed this tutorial, don't forget to like, subscribe, and stay updated on the latest tutorials from iRender. Keep exploring, keep creating, and as always, happy rendering!